Let's get started!
What is wrong, little person?
The babysitter's gonna be a little late today. Go cheer up the little person while I get this thing ready.
I saw a woman do this. Yeah.
Well, at least it's not sad anymore. Let's begin. Oh, would you look at that? Another chapter dropped. That means it's time for another ant, because all we do are ants. Now for this video we are only gonna be talking about this guy. No joking about the UA building. And no bashing handyman. Let's start.
Power! Power!
Great snake!
This is Wallhack. He suddenly appeared out of nowhere after disappearing for so long. His arrival didn't get foreshadowed. Nor other characters even talked about him. He just popped into existence. He also didn't even get to be drawn as a background character all this time. You would think he's with this kid. But he's not there either. He literally disappeared after his little war arc stunt. Not only that, his entrance only has him appear out of the ground. It would have made much more sense if he went up saying something about the underground engine bay. Or he reintroduced himself jumping out of a jet yelling about a small villain group he had to beat, that's why he's late. He didn't do any of those. In fact, the jets have been missing for quite some time now. Where did they go? Are they going after Falcon? Then how come the heroes didn't even mention them doing it? One speech balloon is all it would take. Going back, why is Wallhack shown here like he's some kind of super weapon about to shift the tide of battle? What exactly can he do against a regenerating enemy that's almost invulnerable to physical damage? He has barely any firepower when compared to his buddies. Although he's very good at avoiding damage. Out of all the battles he could appear in, he went into the one where he can't do anything. He's already late to the party back in the war arc. And he's still late now. He's always at the wrong place at the wrong time. Why is he not out there destroying some PLF losers? Imagine him in one of these areas, he'll absolutely destroy everyone here without even getting hit once. He'll utterly wipe out an area in a matter of minutes, seeing how incredibly useless the PLF remnants are.
Power!
But no, that would make the fight easy. We're in the finale and we need to introduce as much artificial difficulty as possible. Just like how every school is heavily fortified and modified. Yet the big boy holding cell is just a simple structure in the middle of an open field. No fortified walls, no watchtowers, and no jets. The villains literally just walk there. Plot holes aside, let's go back to Wallhack. Since he can't damage Handyman in any way, let's see how he can be useful. What if he acted as a distraction, randomly punching Handyman every few seconds? That's good and all. But we already have Paper Thin, Mr. Number 4. This guy can pierce through the masses of giant flesh, and act as both distraction and damage dealer. In theory, he can go through everything Handyman can throw at him. Reach the main body, and destroy Handyman outright. He's even aerodynamic enough to resist shockwaves. His skills at threading and cabling around are second to none. Speaking of cables, would it work if Atomic Wedgie lifted up a few cables, connected them to the electric barrier, and then used them to electrocute Handyman? I mean, it would work, right? Okay, let's be serious here. This guy is a far better distraction than Wallhack. He can't even save people effectively since his intangibility only works on himself. But all in all, let's not get mad at Wallhack just yet. For all the people excited to see him whoop ass with his other big three buddies, there is hope. He'll not be a wasted character this time around. Let's not forget we are still in MHA, where fights are decided not by skill, power, nor talent, but by flashbacks. Flashbacks give enormous power-ups the same way quirk-enhancing drugs do. Look how easily this guy annihilated the Demon King solo, just because he got powered up by a flashback. Maybe this could be the reason why everyone's fine with the UA building getting destroyed. Because flashbacks teach more than schools. In regards to Wallhack, all it would take is a little reminiscing of the one time he ate his veggies. And bam, he gets a power up. Even better, he could be like McBoy. Who suddenly reappeared some chapters at the start of the finale, and suddenly got new abilities because he apparently trained off screen. High chance Wallhack will get fancy new abilities next chapter. It's either he can now share his intangibility to other people. Or he can now supercharge his ascent to hit Handaman with a megaton punch. Because who the f needs actual training these days? Also, a lot of people are pissed off at the creator for this guy not doing anything meaningful with his super attack, and then his arm being broken afterwards. Let's not worry about Gaw too much. Another character got his arm torn off a few chapters ago, and it resulted in the biggest curb stomping in the history of MHA. This guy's just gonna get his own flashback and then destroy Handaman with only one arm, with his unlimited sweat as usual. Before we end, let's check out the food fight, the one who fights with food. He's right there, casually biting on his finger. He's probably wondering if he can also do the Handaman hand thing. Oh, hello there, Miss Mindlayer. Glad you could make it in time. Now we have an excuse to end the video.